This is Catalina Island, 27 miles off the coast of Los Angeles. A place known for its beauty, both above and below the ocean that surrounds it. Most of the fish that call these waters home go relatively unnoticed, but one species is nearly impossible to miss. Leopard sharks, hundreds of them. So, if you were the director of Cal State Long Beach's shark lab, and you're trying to revolutionize the way sharks are studied, it's not a bad place to set up shop.
This is gonna change how we study animals in the ocean. I believe this is gonna change how we do it.
Chris Lowe is the director of Cal State Long Beach's shark lab. And getting to know him and his work means getting your feet wet.
Obviously, here, a day at the office requires a different attire, and it also provides a different view of the world.
It takes only a few moments underwater to understand Chris Lowe's passion for the ocean and for the sharks he studies.
I grew up on Martha's Vineyard, so I lived on an island. And all there was to do was fish and swim and get in the water and dive. Well, when I caught my first shark, there was something about it that just got me.
It was the look.
It looked so different from all the other fish I caught, and it seemed so streamlined, so sleek, that it just didn't match all the other fish I caught.
What is it about sharks that interests you from a scientific perspective?
They're model species. Most of them, not all of them, but a lot of them are at the top of the food chain.
Okay.
And I look at those as our canary. They're a canary in the coal mine for our oceans. They tell us how healthy our oceans are. The challenges are really hard to study. Because as a diver, you jump in the water and you want the sharks to come to you. And sometimes they do, and most times they don't. So that's always been the tricky part. How do we find a way of studying them where we don't have to be right there, potentially influencing their behavior?
The answer, he believes, is this.
This here might look like a torpedo, but this is the robot that we've been talking about. And Chris Clark, you are the man behind this. Tell me about it.
So we've got this autonomous underwater vehicle, AUV, and you typically deploy it in the ocean to go collect data. Mm-hmm. In this project, we want to collect data about sharks. Once it dives down, it uses a couple other sensors, compass, and something called the Doppler velocity log.
What are the sensors and what are they doing?
So we attach some sensors that listen for the sharks. They listen for a tag that we attach to the sharks. Mm-hmm. And we basically put this thing in the water. It listens for the tags attached to the sharks, and it will actually autonomously drive around and follow the sharks as they move. What we've got here are some dummy plugs, and these will actually attach to what we call hydrophones, which is like a microphone, but goes underwater. In this project, in particular, those hydrophones are actually listening for some acoustic tags, and these are things about this big that we will actually attach to a fish or shark, and every 2 seconds they'll just ping, ping.
So these robots have been used for about a decade now. Oceanographers have used them to go out and measure all different sorts of things in the ocean, water temperature and light and salinity and chlorophyll, all the things that oceanographers want to know that characterize the ocean. What we're doing is we're asking the robots to do one more thing. We're asking them to not only do that, but we want them to actually follow a shark and characterize the environment while they're following the shark so that we can build a 3D map around the animal that it's tracking. And it knows exactly where the animal is in that 3D space as it's moving. So our goal is to be able to say, when the animal suddenly does something different, is there some aspect of its environment that's causing it to do that? And we haven't been able to do this before. It's revolutionizing how we're going about studying the animals that we've known nothing about. For example, you have a fishery offshore, and they've been fishing a species, and what happens is the catch rates start to go down. So immediately the managers go, oh my gosh, this fishery is being overfished.
Yeah.
But how do you know, just like when I was a boy, that the fish didn't move away? I mean, it's a possibility. Our ability to understand that means managers can better manage fisheries. We can better manage many of our fish stocks. So that's just one example of how knowing where animals go can be beneficial in terms of management.
Of course, all this is easier said than done, which is why the group comes to Catalina, testing.
So the experiment that we're doing now is we're hiding the transmitter on the seafloor. We're gonna then send the robot out to try to find it and get as accurate a position on it as possible.
The two Chris's know they've hit the mark when the robot locks in on the target and starts circling around. And guess what? It's circling now.
Tell me what that's like for you, having gone from, you know, falling in love as a boy to now, you know, using really, really advanced technologies to understand them better.
Cool part for me was going from being a kid asking those really basic questions. I'm still asking those really basic questions, but we have so much better tools.
What's the end game here for you? How do you see this technology changing the way you do marine science and the way we understand the biosphere for that matter?
I envision a day when we're gonna have fleets of these robots, and they're gonna enable us to do things that we've never been able to do before. Measure aspects of behavior that we've never been able to measure before. And we're gonna build a database of the ocean that's never been created at this scale. So I think this is gonna change our field.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology is a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.